So now we arrive at the question of how to pick search directions. And you know, we want to be able to pick these search directions relatively cheaply. So either we want to compute them from values that we already have computed as part of previous iterations, or you know, we just want to pick them conveniently. Well, what's the most convenient vector you can think of? You might think, well, the zero vector, right? Well, if you pick the zero vector for your search direction, you're not going to get very far. So let's skip that one. But the next most convenient set of vectors are the standard basis vectors. Remember, these are the vectors where you have a 1, that's the first standard basis vector, and then you have the second standard basis vector, and so forth. Now, you're going to do a homework in which you show that if you take the first standard basis vector to be your first search direction, then you actually do exactly the update that you did when you did the Gauss Seidel iteration. Interesting. And then you're going to ponder through, well, what if I cycle through the standard basis vectors? What if I take my first search direction to be E0, then E1, E2, and so forth? And once I get to the end of them, what if I just go right back to the beginning? Well, you're going to have some interesting insights when you do that. Go think about it for a bit.